Alright, so we got an empty map and something all the way on the other side of the map. So this is going to be an interesting fight. Oh, dead end. Alright, I need to either rejuvenate or bridge. One or the other. Woohoo! I got myself a bridge! Alright, update my map. Thank you. Surprise! This is an interesting looking location. I mean, it certainly doesn't seem like it should be massive. But then again, I guess it's a little misleading too, because I'm not quite sure what's going on. Oh. Okay. What just happened there? Do I even have anything to cure, like, curse? Rather than, like... Where's curse be gone? Then all I gotta do is... Oh my gosh! Okay, seriously. Stop it. Oh, that may have been a bit too much. Ah! Wonder what this is. And where do you think you're going? You can speak! How very observant of you, boy. Now let's have a look at you. Oh dear. Oh dear me. It would seem you are alive and well. This will not do. This will not do at all. I cannot let you pass. We'll have no heartbeat here. This area is strictly corpses only. Really? But we won't cause any trouble. Honest, we won't. Please let us pass, Mr. Skeleton. Over my live body. The only way you're getting past me is dead, just like everyone else. Is that clear? You'll only let us pass if we're dead. It's asking kind of a lot, you know. You think just because we're dead we have no principles? No code of conduct to die by? So long as you breathe, you're barred. Live with it. What are we going to do? Simple. We do as the man says, eh, dude? Time for a spot to die in, I reckon. Huh? You don't mean you want us to... Don't be daft, Mon. I'm not asking you to actually die. Just pretend like. It ain't that hard. Pretend to be dead. But how? With magic, of course. Now get that spellbook of yours out and find us a spell that lets you pretend you're dead. There's really a spell for that. Okay, I guess I'll take a look. Oh. Huh? Creates a poisoned apple that induces a death-like state when eaten. That sounds like the spell I need. Come on. Alright, we got Gateway. Take heart, give heart, draw poison, springlock, nature's tongue, levitate, bridge, puppet string, magic lamp, form familiar, quicken growth, rejuvenate, secret ingredient, spirit medium, poison apple. Yeah, it looks like poison apple's the only thing I need. So I mean, like, what am I supposed to do? This is the domain of the deceased. No heartbeats allowed. Of course, I'll happily consider letting you pass when you're dead. There we go. I'll commit this act of treason right in front of you.
Ha 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 ha!
Not a pus among... Pus? Not a pulse among them. They're dead! Dead! Come here, quick! Fresh corpses, boys! The first in years! And don't start burying us! Oliver! Oliver, wake up! Hey, it looks like we made it. Made it into another graveyard, at least. So does this mean... Wakey wakey, risen already, I see. Whoa, what's that? Why, I'm your new friend. We're all friends now. Lucky you. I'm not gonna do the stutter thing. But thanks. Now, to commemorate the happy event of your death, allow me to present you with this key. Here you are. Skeleton. Skeleton key, I got it. What's this? I'm glad you asked. You see, here on the Tombstone Trail, we don't think that you have to stop having fun just because you're dead. That's why we're currently in the process of building a magnificent casino. As soon as it opens, you can use that key to let yourself in and start enjoying the millionaire death style. A casino? That's right. A place where the discerning dead can go when they want to die. A little. It takes a few decades to build, but the wait will be worth it. A few decades? Well, there's no rush, is there? We're all dead, after all. I guess so. Thank you, mister. I've got the same one. For a corpse animated by arcane magics from the dark beyond, that skeleton is proper friendly. It's not something I want to make into a habit of associating myself with the dead. What is with all the zombos? Wait, wrong direction. Ah! What's all this then? A little run-down shack, is it? It doesn't look like anybody's lived here for a long time. Well, that'll do nicely then. Let's have a kip, shall we? Are you sure that's a good idea, Mr. Drippy? I mean, it looks kind of creepy. But I guess we could rest here for a little while. Alright, Marcuson. Do it, just like I told you. Okay. It's no good. I'm sorry, Gascon. I just can't do it. Marcuson, are you lying to me?
What?
I know you can do it. You're just pretending that you can't.
No, I'm not pretending.
You are. Why would you do something like that?
I'm not pretending. I'm really not.
Hey, you shouldn't pick on your little brother like that. I wasn't picking on him. I just want to know the truth.
Well, there's no need to be so pushy. I'm sure he'll be able to cast that spell before long.
Don't you see? He can already cast that spell. He can cast loads of spells.
Huh?
He's always been able to, and now all of a sudden he's pretending that he can't. Why would he do that? Maybe he enjoys watching Father tell me off. Do you really think that's it, Gascon?
Eh?
Marcuson hates seeing you get told off, but he'd hate being separated from you even more.
What are you...
Only those who are capable of becoming sages can ascend to the throne of Hamelin. Isn't that right?
How can you... What are you saying that for?
Because Marcuson knows it too. He knows that if he were to show promise as a sage, if he showed himself worthy of being emperor, well, I don't need to tell you what would happen. That's why he keeps pretending to be no good at magic.
What are you... How do you know all this?
I don't know what to tell you. All I can say is that it isn't a situation I'd wish on anyone.
It doesn't matter. I want Marcuson to become a powerful wizard.
I won't let you stop me helping that happen, no matter who you are. I know you won't. Hell, I wouldn't.
Huh.
Wonder what that means.
Flippin' heck, this robot's taking a proper battering.
Hey, you don't reckon robots have good ghosts, do you? Well, if we don't go touching it, we won't get any robot spheres clanking after us. Come on, Ollie boy, on we go. I'm guessing it's not gonna let me in there now. Well, and I didn't get fully healed from it either. That's pointless. Still got like half the map to go, so I'm gonna call it a credit right here. And when we return, well, when we return, we'll end up finishing this place off. I'm certain of it. Is it just me, or did it get a lot darker all of a sudden? I don't like the look of this. Can't see where I'm going. It's too dark.
Come on, Ollie boy. Use your head. You've got the perfect spell for brightening things up for a bit, ain't it?
You're right. Too late. Already done it.
If you pass through this cave, you'll find a mighty altar. Or you would if the path weren't blocked. They say that candlelight may open the way ahead, but I'm afraid I don't have a light. Come on, Ollie boy, brighten things up a bit, will ya?
What are you trying to do, Mon? You need to light the things, not melt them into a flippin' puddle. Okay. If everything goes as planned, we should be eventually getting to somewhere important. Bah, the path's blocked good and proper. No amount of pushing and shoving will get us through here. Maybe there's some sort of trick of it. But that does seem a bit far-fetched. Feel that shaking just now? What about all that noise from over by the other side? Maybe my lantern rattle, mon. Hold on, my fairy senses tell me we might be able to carry up on the path now. And my fairy senses never lie. Yay! Alright, here we are, finally within reach of the final location. I mean, it doesn't look like there's much left on the map.
Yep, there's where I need to be. And this seems to be a bit open, so I mean, I can just imagine a fight's fixing to happen. But before I go straight to it, I want to see if there's any chests over here. I mean, it just looks like the sort of place that you would end up finding something hidden in the corner, you know? Oh well.
What's going on?
Candelabra Cadabra. Ghoulish guardian of the great
that
ones.
Flipping great candle must be guardian monster!
Well then, I guess we're gonna have to prove we've got what it takes to get it. Everybody ready?
Hopefully this isn't anything like how it was last time. that spell just does not seem to want to work. If it's a giant ghost. Okay, here we go. Here's a handy hint for you, Ollie boy. Evil types that use a lot of darkness attacks are weak against light attacks. So it's just as well the Emperor gave you that spell, ain't it? You know the one I'm talking about, don't you? The lighty one, yeah. This is what you're talking about, right?
Ah, go away, go away!
He sure does have a whole lot of special attacks. Go, go, go! Go, go! Get it! Where's it at?
No! It disappeared!
Oh, he got it. That works too.
Whoa!
Meh. Still hope my magic hits.
Yes, it did.
Of course, it's also the most costly of the spells I've got, so this is not anything. Oh, sorry about that. Oh, come on! Okay, so snuff out does darkness. Boo does curse.
Ah. Really, Esther?
Oh, you've gotta be kidding me.
Leave it to me!
Damn it, girl.
Thank you.
That's one good thing about Epitaph, though. Man, that scared me for a second there. What? He's still not dead. Provisions. There we go. Just what the doctor ordered. Some more magic. If it wasn't for him constantly spamming everything, it'd be easier. One thing. At least he's predictable. I can do at least one attack in between each of his. Oh no! That's not good. Ooh, ooh.
Esther, me.
Do I get to use it, or...? Oh, you've got to be kidding me! Liking this right now. It's like, oh, we'll let you do what we want you to do when we want you to do it. Not any other time in between. Because, you know, that would be totally convenient for you, but not for us. So, boo-hoo on you. Oh, come on! Blank you, mother blinker!
Is that it?
Well, at least only one person died this fight. Marcusin, that spell, did you?
Yes.
You did it, Marcusin. You got him. That was amazing.
Thanks, Gaskin.
Marcusin, you saved us. Thank you.
Oh, it was nothing. Now hurry, let's get Mornstar.
He's right, you know. Come on, Ollie boy. Let's head for that altar, ain't it? Oh my gosh.
The legendary wand must be in here.
Look! at that! What a beauty! It may be older than my mom, but it's still got a bucket load of oomph!
So this is the legendary wand. Morningstar.
You have done well.
Who are you?
I am one who guides the fate of this world. And yes, it was I who summoned you here to this time.
Huh?
I had scant choice but to bring you here. For in your time, Morningstar has been mislaid. For my boldness, you must accept my apologies. Know that countless trials lie ahead of you still. Steel yourselves and fix your sights upon your goal. Until the day when you finally arrive, I shall be waiting.
He's gone.
Breach time, eh? I suppose the rumors about you lot coming from the future are too, then. I've never seen any masked wizards here in Hamelin before, though. Have you, Markison?
No, never.
Well, let's head back to Hamelin for now, Oliver. We need to take the princes back to their father. Yeah. Are you okay, Gaskin? Oh, shoot. What is that? What is that? What is that? What is that? What is it? Oh my gosh, yes! Hell yeah! Freedom! I'm sorry, everyone, but this is where I say goodbye. It's time we went our separate ways. Huh? What are you talking about? Aren't you coming back to Hamelin with us? No, I'm not going back. I've got my own journey to go on. Your own journey? You mean you're running away from home? Hey, look after yourself, alright? Here, you better take this. Father gave me that sword, but you're the one who should have it. It's the kind of sword that a sage should wield. A sage like you'll be someday. Hey, don't cry. You don't need to be scared. If you ever get in trouble, I'll come and help you, I promise. Wherever you are, no matter how far away, I'll always be there for you if you need me. Wherever I am? Yes. I promise you, but if I'm going to live up to this promise, I'm going to have to do some training of my own. As Father keeps saying, I need to find my own role within the Empire. I need to find out what I'm good at. I won't let him down. I refuse to be a disappointment.
Alright, but please come back. I'll be waiting for you.
You do that, Markison. We'll meet again one day. You'll see. I wish you and your friends all the best as well, Oliver. I hope you make it back to your time. Thanks, Prince Gaskin. I hope we meet again someday. I don't think you have to call me Prince anymore. Well, goodbye.
Hey! Wait!
What is it?
Are you really sure about this, Gaskin?
It's what I've decided. I'll be better off watching Markison from afar, watching him become a sage. I don't change my mind once I've made a decision. That's the Gaskin way. The Gaskin way? It sounds like you're determined to be your own man.
But I refuse to say goodbye. Let's just say, until next time.
Alright, until next time. In the future. In your time. See you then. Take care, Gaskin. Gosh,
That boy is really stubborn. Now come on, Oliver. Let's head back to our time. Sure thing. Good old Hamlin. Home sweet home.
Oh, the Emperor!
Your Majesty!
Father!
But why? What happened?
Shadar.
Shadar?
Yes. He was here. He came to demand our unconditional surrender.
Huh?
But let it be known, I defied him. I would not bow to that wretch.
No, don't. Don't try to speak.
Gascon.
Huh?
My son. My beloved son.
Huh?
You really thought I couldn't tell?
You knew.
Your appearance may have changed, but I know my own flesh and blood. What the future holds is a mystery to all men. But I know that together you and Marcusan can, I believe it, you protect the Empire now and in the future.
Father! No! Father! Please! Father! I got to meet you again. And now this. I just wanted to make you proud. And now this has to happen! Damn it!
Swain.
No!
I wonder what's taking Swain so long. I just can't believe that he's Gascon. The heir to all of Hamlin. My mind's boggled beyond belief, man. I guess he didn't want us to know, huh? I suppose so. It won't be the same now that we know he's a prince. Well, I'm gonna act like I don't know. Me too. Unless Swain wants to talk about it, I'm not going to say a word. Oh, you don't need to worry about me, Mon. I'll have forgotten all about this in a bit. Couldn't remember it if I wanted to, me. If there's one thing I'm good at, it's forgetting. Sorry to keep you waiting. Swain! I suppose it's time to go, but I need to say goodbye to Marcusan first. Alright. It's today that you're leaving, isn't it? Yes, Your Highness. Thank you for everything. No, I should be thanking you. Because of you, I was able to become my father's heir, and soon I'll formally inherit his title.
Yeah, I bet the people of Hamlin are glad about that and all.
I mean to give them a reason to be. I want them to know that they have nothing to fear from Shadar. I refuse to let him defeat us. I want Gascon to be able to come back to Hamlin whenever he likes, after all. I must keep the Empire safe until he does so.
You'll make a fine Emperor, Marcusan. Gascon would be proud of you.
I hope so. He always believed in me, and I shall never stop believing that he will come back.
Look at your locket, Oli boy. It's all aglow, man. You don't think?
It must be. Marcusan's belief in his brother must be real strong. I'm sorry,
Your Highness, there's someone who needs your help. Someone who needs some of the strength that's in your heart.
My heart? Whoever are you talking about?
Well, you, Your Highness.
In the future, I mean. In our time, a piece of your heart is missing.
My future self.
That's right. And we need you to share some of your belief with him, to help him get back to normal.
My belief.
Very well. I can hardly refuse my own future self a piece of my own heart.
Give me your heart! Ugh.
I will gladly share my heart. Come, take it.
Reach your heart in and pull it out. Rup!
The unshakable faith. Oh, I like that symbol. Thank you very much, Your Highness.
There's no need to thank me. Now please, give that belief to my future self. But before you go, Swain?
Yes?
When you return your time, please give my regards to my future brother.
I'll be sure to do that, Your Highness. Righto, back to the future it is. You know which spell you want, don't you, Ollie boy? Bruce time, ain't it? Roger. Let's go, everyone. To the future. There it is. They better take it out.
Okay, all together.
Today, tomorrow, yesterday, send us safely on our way!
Oliver's gone. They've all gone.
Did we make it? Huh? Are we still in the same place? No way, Mon. That's impossible. I know when a spell works, and that spell worked right and proper. We're back in our time, no doubt about it. Yeah, this place is different somehow. Swain. We made it back, that's all that matters. Now isn't there someone who we should be helping?
Of course. Come on, Oliver. Let's find Marcuson.
Sure thing. Let's go give him his belief back. This way. Yes, this way.
Run faster! Come on!
Get out of here! Go! Be gone, I say!
Poor lad's still broken-hearted, that's for definite. A shadow of his for himself he is. He needs a dose of belief, and he needs a snappy.
Come on, Mon. It's what his dad would have wanted.
Cease your maddening chatter, fairy. My father died 15 years ago. Do not claim to know his will.
So all that carry-on was 15 years ago, was it? And this poor lad's been on his own ever since.
That's tragic.
Your Highness, we brought you something. A gift. It's from 15 years ago. We got it from... well... we got it from you. Anyway, if it's okay, we'd like you to have it back.
What did you say? What is the meaning of this?
What is this? This glow? What's happening? What is this warmth that spreads within my breast? What have I been doing? All this time I have been so misguided.
It was your Shinar, Your Highness. He took the belief from your heart.
My heart? My belief? Wait, I believe in people once more.
I want to believe in people. It has been so long since I felt this way.
Does this mean that you saved me? Was it you who gave me back the capacity to believe?
It was, Your Highness. I did promise, didn't I? I promised I'd come and help you if you were in trouble. Wherever you were, no matter how far away.
Wherever I... I see. Now I see. You came back. I always knew you that you would. Thank you. There's really no need to thank me, Your Highness. Your Highness, we need your help. We want you to help us to defeat Shadar.
What did you say?
You mean defeat Shadar? That is impossibly reckless. I am a great sage, and yet Shadar was able to enter my heart and take a piece of it with impunity. And yet I was saved, just as I was promised.
Very well, I shall assist you. Together we will defeat the Dark Djinn. Shadar's days are numbered.
They sure are. Thank you so much, Your Highness. I knew you wouldn't let us down.
And that is why you're the Emperor, Markison.
Well, well. What are we to make of this? It seems the Savior managed to acquire Mornstar after all.
And somehow managed to travel back to the present. I would have thought that far beyond his meager powers.
Indeed. The power to breach time can be used but once in a mortal's life, can it not?
It would seem that he has benefited from yet more assistance.
And that his benefactor possesses formidable powers.
Powers on a par with our own.
This supposed helper of his is no mere dabbler in the magical arts. Such powers recall those of that ancient king without whom our magic wands could not exist. Yes, I speak of my...
But that would be a truly terrifying proposition, if one such as he were to...
Fear not. Should the need arise, I shall take action myself.
Your radiance, you mean to say...
I do. He cannot hope to defeat me. And I will tell you.
Alright everyone, listen. In order to defeat Shadar, we must first break down his defenses. Now, the Dark Djinn is protected by a magical barrier known as the Black Briar.
The Black Briar?
Yes, it is a glowing magical barrier with which no spell can permeate. Neither Rashad nor Alicia were able to overcome the Black Briar. That is why Shadar was able to defeat them. And with the other great sages incapacitated, he was able to delve deep into my own heart and steal a piece of it.
But now, Markison, I mean, Your Majesty.
Come along now, Esther. I once fought alongside you as a child. There is no need for you to use my royal title. Same goes for all of you.
Sure, Your Majesty.
Don't worry, Oliver. I'm sure you'll get used to it. Now, I would dearly love to accompany you on another journey, one where we grow strong together. Strong enough to defeat Shadar. But protecting the Empire has to be my first priority. There is also the small matter of rectifying the many mistakes I made whilst brokenhearted. I comfort myself with the knowledge that you now possess a wand that should enable you to defeat Shadar without my aid, Oliver. Mornstar once belonged to the Wizard King. It is said to have the power to overcome any enchantment. That must surely include the Black Briar that protects Shadar. Unfortunately, however, the wand you have in your possession is not complete.
Eh?
Not complete? What are you on about? Mornstar's true power is beyond most wizards' comprehension. It is so powerful, indeed, that the ancient king who created it decided that its power should be divided between three magical stones. These three stones were then sealed away, far from the wand itself. So we need to go find them, right? Yes, but I have an apology to make in that regard.
Huh? Well, why? What have you done?
A map detailing the locations of the three stones was once in my possession. I am afraid, however, that it has been stolen.
Stolen?
While I was brokenhearted, I must confess that I became rather neglectful of the palace's treasures. Books and maps would often disappear. To my shame, I actually observed several such thefts, and did nothing.
That sounds about right. I found it hard to care about anything much when I was brokenhearted.
Well, this is a bit flippin' rum. If the thief who pinched the map uses it to get hold of the stones, what do you think he's going to do with them?
I do not know. What I do know, however, is the identity of the thief. His name is Kublai. He styles himself King of the Sky Pirates. Kublai? Of all the people to tangle with. I should have known you two would be thick as Zerm. Anyway, I don't suppose you know where he is, do you? That's the thing with the Sky Pirates. You never know where they are. They're always moving from hideout to hideout on these giant airships. Be that as it may, locating Kublai is still the easiest way for you to recover the 3 magical stones. He is very unlikely to cooperate peacefully, however. I'd better teach you some new spells, Oliver. Ward. Fuse. Insight. You will almost certainly be doing a lot of traveling on your search for Kublai. Therefore, let me grant you one last spell. Yes! Travel! What does it do, your, Markison? It instantly transports you to any location you've already visited. While I'm unable to accompany you in your travels, I can at least make them pass more comfortably.
That's great! And it means we can come and see you anytime we'd like, Markison.
Indeed. Be sure to use it to return to some of the other places you had visited on your journey and find out what has changed. If you visit the Temple of Trials, for example, you will now be able to take part in the Solosseum series, organized by my old teacher, Solomon.
Oh, wow. I'd almost completely forgotten about Solomon and the Temple of Trials.
Our first priority, though, is to find Kublai, King of the Sky Pirates. Come on, Oliver. The next chapter of our adventure starts here.
It sure does. Let's go.
I wonder if I can use this right now. Travel. We go back here.
Bye! That's awesome!
Wow. Wait, where is it? Oh, it's all the way on the other side?
Huh. I don't think I've been over there.
Well, that means we've got a lot of exploring to do. And that also means I'm going to go ahead and try and do all of the additional errands that I have left to do. So, until next time, take care.